Yeah, hi everyone. Today we will talk about the how to create the basic pivot table in pivot chart. As you can see, this is one of the chart and pivot table we are going to create today. I have the sample data in the data tab. This is a superstore sample data, and we'll create the pivot table in pivot chart using this data. Okay, first you need to select all this data and go to insert option, where you can see different options, and we'll select pivot table. And here by default it will select the table and range of the data, and where you want to create this pivot table in pivot chart, in the existing worksheet or the new worksheet. So we'll go ahead and select a new worksheet and click on OK. So now you can see the sheet 2, and you can see when you click on the this area, you can see on the right hand side different fields that we have in our data source or data that we saw. And from here you can select any of the field. For this example, we'll take product subcategory and drag it onto rows, and here you can see right away you can see all these product subcategories are listed down here. And for values, we'll take sales. Either you can select from the list or you can directly search in the search box and drag sales onto values. By default it will take some aggregation of the field, but you can change it to count, average, max, min. Okay, for the example I will keep it sum, and as of now it is showing all the different subcategories and their sales. And but I would like to see in a descending order the highest one on the top and the lowest one in the on the bottom. Okay, I will right click on this pivot table area and go to sort and select sort largest to smallest, where it will sort based on the highest value to lowest value. And to see the table clearly, so I would remove this decimal place, two decimals. For this, we need to click on the area and select value field settings. Click on the number format, and here we can see different options. So I will select number, and the decimal places I will keep it as 0. Okay, if you want to keep the thousand separator, you just need to click on the use thousand separator. Click on OK and click OK again. And here you can see the values clearly. And if you want to change the sum of sales heading, click on the pivot click on the value field settings, and you can give any name that you want for the column. So I will give it like total sales. Okay, so right away it will change from the sum of sales to total sales, so you can do customization. Okay, so from here I would like to create a pivot chart based on this data, and for this you need to go to pivot table and analyze tab, where you can see different options. Okay, for this I will take the pivot chart. Click on the pivot chart. Yeah, click on pivot chart and click on the any of the chart type you want. I will click on the bar, and you can able to select any of the bar chart type that you want. For this example, I will take this basic cluster bar chart and click on OK. And so immediately we'll get this output of the chart. But for this example, I don't need any of these buttons, so I'll click on the buttons, right click on it and hide all field buttons on chart. But to show the bars from the descending to ascending, click on the bars, right click and format data series option. So on the right hand side it will create one window to format, and just a minute, chart area. sorry, not this one. And yeah, click on the different subcategories, right click on it and format axis, and go down and click on the categories in reverse order. So what you'll do, it will create the highest to lowest, and I will close this one. And so I will remove this value axis, and I will remove this as well. So for this one, I'll rename the title. So I will give it as a sales by product subcategory. Okay, and click on any of the part of the chart, and I want to see the bars with some width. So click on the bars and click on the this option where it is saying that series options, and gap width, you can reduce, you need to reduce the gap width like the using the slider option. So right away you can see the change, and I will expand this chart area so I can able to see this clearly. And if you want to see the labels for the values, you need to click on the plus sign button, and you need to select data labels, and I will expand this chart area, and I will remove these grid lines to see the chart clearly. And yeah, that's it. So we can see the clear and nice looking bar chart with a table. I hope you enjoy this video. Thanks everyone.